Are you overwhelmed by an endless to-do list, or are you noting down things on paper and then you can't find them anymore? I promise you, by the end of this video, you're going to be excited about your to-do list again. Hello, it's Kat. Welcome back to my channel, where I help you to implement better systems in your business so that you can spend more time on the things that you enjoy. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can plan and organize the tasks in your business in ClickUp so that it becomes fun and achievable instead of stressful and overwhelming. Trust me, I know exactly what it feels like when you're to-do list is like never ending, especially since I had baby number two. The mental load can be like insane, and mom brain is a real thing. And so I was so relieved when I found ClickUp, and I kind of outsourced all of my head into this program. And I know that I'm not going to forget about it. I'm going to be reminded, and eventually it's going to get done. By the way, if you want to know more about how I organize my work day with a baby at home, then check out this video here where I go a bit more into detail of my routines and also some of the stuff that we're going to talk about here, how I sort of categorize my tasks. I explain a bit further in there, so have a look at that. And also, if you're completely new to ClickUp, you might want to check out this video here first, because I'm just going to go through the basic functionality and give you some inspiration of how it can look like and how it can help you to run your business so much easier. So enough talking, let's get into the daily schedule in ClickUp. So in ClickUp, all of the tasks are arranged in spaces, folders, lists, and then tasks. So I just tend to use this everything tab here, which just shows you everything that is in these spaces here. Ideally, the tasks are derived from your goals. If you want to know how to do that, keep an eye out for the next video, where I'm going to go a bit deeper into how to plan your goals with ClickUp and then how to get the tasks from that. But for now, we're just going to use whatever is in here already. Whatever, I'm just going to show you how I sort of organize them and do my daily schedule. As I said, this is pulling in all the tasks from everywhere in ClickUp, so nothing gets missed. Everything is in here. You can filter. I have filtered out my templates folder because these are just dummy tasks. And then I literally just have this one big list, and it shows tasks and also subtasks of tasks. You can turn this on and off as you like here. I tend to turn this on and off depending on what I do. So at the moment, as I'm doing YouTube, I have a lot of subtasks. So I do keep this and also the parent task name, so I know where it's coming from. But usually I also turn this off at times to make it a bit easier to see, because it's quite a long list. So one of the things that I really love about ClickUp is time estimate. Every task that I have, I try to put an estimate of time there, because then what you can do is you can click here and it'll calculate the times. Yeah, so if I would have had time here everywhere, which I should have, it would just calculate me the time. So as I can see for today, that is a lot of tasks. So you probably, and you'll know how much you can schedule for the day with buffer times that you can get done. But this thing just really, really helps me to not over schedule myself, because I tend to do that a lot. And this one is just a general due date, which is obviously today. We can also have these recurring tasks. So for every task, you can set the time when it happens, or recurring tasks, which is amazing because once you tick them off. So for example, I do have lunch in my schedule. It'll just pop that back in tomorrow so that I don't forget to have lunch. So the other thing that I do is a task category, and this might look different for you. I categorize into three categories, which is deep work, busy work, and after work. And I have another video where I go deeper into that. If you want to watch that, I'll just put the link in the description of what these means. Essentially, these come from working from home with a baby. So deep work is whenever I can actually focus on things and there are no kids around. And busy work is whatever tasks I can do when there are kids around, so things where I can be interrupted and it doesn't matter so much. And then after work, whatever I need to do after work that shouldn't be done in my sort of work hours. That's just how I categorize them. So as I said, this might look different for you. You can easily edit this field and just change them up as you like, and then also to sort them. So I usually have these ones first because these are usually the most important things that I want to get done. So also, this is grouped by due date because obviously I want to know what's happening today. Also, you can see things that are maybe overdue that you forgot, so that's quite helpful. There are a lot of other options of what you can show here. You can literally add to the columns whatever you want. You can put in the task location, where it sits, in which space, and so on. You can show also the closed tasks if you wanted to. And if you click on this little plus icon here, you can add a column. So you can add
everything. You can, as I said, ClickUp is really, really customizable. You can literally make this look like you want to. You can, if you go to show and hide here, you can see, and you scroll down, you can basically tick and untick all of the fields that you want to show here. So if you, for example, work with a team and you have different assignees, you can add that in here as well. Another way to look at it is the calendar view. So it shows you exactly the same task, just in the calendar view. You can also change settings here. So for example, if you don't want to see the weekend, you can just turn that off here. You can fade out tasks in the past to make it easier to see. You can blend in week numbers, or that sort of stuff. A really nice thing is the color coding here, which is set to by list. So wherever this is coming from, which list, so you can straight away see, hey, this is from, so yellow for me is marketing, so this is marketing task, and so on and so forth. You can also add some more information to these things if you want. So you could put in the locations of which space and folder this actually lives in, if you don't remember the colors, and any sort of custom fields that you might have. For example, add this task category, so I can see here, okay, I've got, this is a deep work, this is a busy task, and so on. But for me, that goes a bit too much into detail. I'd rather look at the list. But this one is really good for planning sort of launches or holidays or whatever you're doing, because you can also plan over, as you can see here, over the day. So just to sort of plan your schedule. Another thing you can do is to connect your calendar. So you can connect, add a calendar through here, your Google Calendar. So you can go two ways. You can either add your ClickUp task into your Google's calendar, which I think is a bit too much, or it can feed your Google Calendar task into here, which, for example, if you take calls or discovery calls, that might be helpful to add it in here so that you know what you've got going on the day.
If you're enjoying this video so far, please hit the like button and consider subscribing. I'd appreciate it so much, and it helps me to create more videos like this for you. Okay, so let's get back into ClickUp and I'll show you how you can build out this daily schedule for yourself. If you don't want to follow along and you want to save the time, you can also just grab this template in my brand new template shop. You can find the link in the description. Otherwise, just keep following along.
Okay, so let me show you how you can build this up. This is like a brand new ClickUp account. This is how it looks like when you first sign up. If you're already using ClickUp, this might look different for you, and you might have already a couple of spaces, lists, and folders here, which is great. Then you don't need to do this, but I'm gonna just create a couple of lists with tasks so that I've got something to work with here. So maybe a personal to do. If you do have a brand new account, you might want to do the same. So just, here's already a list, so I'm just going to rename it into like a business to do and a personal to do. This is literally how I started my ClickUp as well. I don't overcomplicate it and create lots of things. You can just literally start like this. So business to do, we already have these dummy tasks in here, which I'm just going to keep. And then personal, we might just add a couple like book, doc, appointment, call, Sarah, sign up to the gym, or go to the gym, whatever it is. So these are our to-dos. Okay, so now we want to use that task category. So I'm just going to add this here for now at this space level, because that's all what I have anyway. So we're just going to click on these three little dots here and go to more settings and custom fields. Custom fields, you can do a whole lot of things and add information. So we're going to use a drop down here, which is called task category, or whatever makes sense to you. And then we're just going to call it deep work, busy work, and after work. And you can color code these as you like. I've added my own colors to that, but let's just sort of make it similar. You can add your brand colors, and that's it. We've added that. And so now if we go to the everything tab here and to this little plus sign here to add a column, go to show and hide. We can't unfortunately see our field here, so we're just going to click on use existing field. We have drop downs here. Use this field. So you're going to add this in, and now there's nothing in there yet. We can move this over to the left side, and let's say this is a deep work task, this is a busy work task. Just gonna put some random things in here. So now we've got these all categorized, and we want to change this here. At the moment it's grouped by status. We don't really want that. We rather want it by due date, because I want to know what is happening when. And then we want to sort this by task category, so I know, okay, this is actually overdue, let's change this to today just for the sake of it. Here we go. And so now we can see this is due today. This is a deep work, busy task. Assignee usually would be you or whoever you're working with. So you can keep this or get rid of it depending on how important that is for you. You can also filter this view here and make sure that this is only showing your task. If you only want to see your own task, or if you are working with people, you might want to see all of the tasks that are going on. You can also create another list here. So save this one for example, only your task, and then you create another list for all of the tasks. Now, the other thing that we want to add in is this time estimation functionality. And in order to do that, we actually need to add this functionality in. So it's called Click Apps. So in order to add that in, we got to go down here to the settings and add in this Click Apps, it's called. So we can just search for time estimation and time estimates. Here you go. And this is also where you can set sort of your hours per day. So how many work hours do you have? And you can enable this for different spaces, but we'll just leave this all on for everything so that is turned on. Now we got to go back into our lists here. So I'm just going to quickly add in these task category in here as well. Move that over so it looks the same way. We're also going to group this by due date. For these ones, we don't have anything set, so let's just put that in here just so that we've got something there. There we go. And I'm going to get rid of this priority. You can keep that if you like. And then we want to add in the estimation time estimate. Here go, 15 minutes and so on and so forth. And now we can go back to our everything view here and just add this time estimate in here and just move that over. This should be sorted. Oh yeah, well, we forgot that, did we? So as you can see, this has all changed back to what it was because I didn't save it. So I'm going to change this back. So I'm just going to pin this list here. And then what we're going to do is to go in these three dots here and do autosave view so that it actually keeps it how we set it up. Okay, so now we've got our task category here. Then we have the time estimate. We can sort after that. And as I said, we wanted to calculate it. Now, this is the only thing, for whatever reason, this one, you need to have the paid version of ClickUp. Everything else so far we could do with the free one. I have got this as well, and I think it is well worth it. It comes up to like $60 a year, and it still is very low cost for the functionality that you get for it. Now, this is our list view. If you wanted to, you can have a whole lot of other views, but if we just want to have this calendar here, we can set that up as well. So again, we want to do auto save here and maybe pin this. I like to pin this. You could also filter this in case you only wanted to have a work task calendar. So you could say list or location is business to do here. So then it'll only show you your business task. You can move things on here, or you can change the status. So if this is done, you can tick this off in here. And so yeah, this is how you can build this daily schedule in ClickUp. So there you have it. This is the way I organize my tasks in ClickUp, and it has helped me so much to consistently work on the actual important tasks and to move towards my goal. By the way, if you want to know more about how to set your goals and then kind of get your tasks from that, keep an eye out for the next video where I'm going to go exactly through that. Also, again, I just want to let you know, if you want to dive deeper into ClickUp and you want to learn all the tricks of how you can run your business better with ClickUp, then have a look in the description as well. There's a link to the waitlist of my soon coming ClickUp mini course. In the meantime, you can also check out this playlist here, which is full of other tutorials about ClickUp. Now, have an amazing day, and I can't wait to see you again in the next video.